guys, welcome back to my channel. And I'm going to be doing the Gold Luster Bus by Ron Fink and John Heth. So these are all the characters: Luzina Wilson, Becky, John Sutter, James Marshall, Gold Fever Singers, Overlanders, Sam, Argonauts, Pan Miners, Carnival Barker, Johnny the Announcer, Children, Merchants, and City Miners. So the singers are Gold Fever Singers, Overlanders, Argonauts, Pan Miners, Children, Merchants, and City Miners. So the part that I'm doing for school is Argonauts, but today I'm going to be doing the whole play by myself. I'm going to be doing the boys, the girls, the singers, anything. So let's begin. So we've already made hand gestures in my class, so yeah, this is the beginning. Sleepy Northern California in 1848. We got ranchos and steers, just a few pioneers and tons of real estate. Okay, let me stand up so you guys can see it. So this is back. I think it should be over here. Okay. Sleepy Northern California in 1848. There's no smog in the air. We've got grizzly bears and we're not yet a state. So grab your picks and shovels, friends. It's all gonna change real soon. Gold Dust or Bus. Gold Dust or Bus. Start singing a different tune. And then that's when the violin plays and you have to play like this. Abandoned ships will fill the bay. They bother floating around. We can't keep the crews when they hear the news that gold's been found. Eggs will cost $3 each. You'll live in just a shack. It's too much for four. It's too much for some. But most return are going back. So grab your picks and shovels, friends. It's all gonna change real soon. Gold Dust or Bus. Gold Dust or Bus. Start singing a different tune. Gold Dust or Bus. Gold Dust or Bus. Gold Dust or Bus. Gold Dust or Bus. So that was a song called Sleepy in California. So this is Luzina. Hello, my name is Luzina Wilson. I was one of the first women to come to California during the Gold Rush. This is my friend Becky and we'll be your guides today. You're in luck. It's January 24th, 1848, and we're near Sacramento at a new sawmill owned by John Sutter. Luzina, you know what happened here on this faithful day. I sure do. It's the day I discovered gold and started the Gold Rush. I was fishing for a trout and accidentally hooked a gold nugget the size of a land river. The rest is history. Becky, let's not start that again. Becky, that's a lie a bit. So this, I forgot to tell you guys, but this show is about 30 minutes. So, yeah. I remember it was yesterday. That nugget was putting up a heck of a fight. I was using a 10-pound line and a peanut butter sandwich when, Becky, we're here to watch a man named James Marshall discover gold on land owned by John Sutter. Here they are. Captain Sutter, we found gold near your sawmill. Are you sure? Absolutely, I had to test it. We've got gold on your land. Gold! Quiet down, Marshall. We need to keep this just between me and you. So that was Sutter and Marshall. So now this is where Sutter sings. It's called "It's Our Little Secret." So this is the beginning. It's our little secret. It's just between us. Our little secret. Let's not make a fuss. Our little secret. We won't tell a soul. Nobody needs to find out. We found gold. It's our little secret. We'll just tell our friends. Maybe a cousin, but that's where it ends. Our little secret, we don't have a doubt. No way our secret can ever get out. We found gold. We found gold. We found gold. But it's a secret. It's our little secret, so don't talk too loud. If we are careful, we won't draw a crowd. Our little secret, no one here will cheat. No, we are the masters of being discreet. We found gold. We found gold. We found gold. We found gold. But it's a secret. A secret, a secret, a secret. It's our little secret. It's just between us. Our little secret, let's not make a fuss. Our little secret, we won't tell a soul. Nobody needs to find out. We found gold. Yeah! Of course, the secret was soon out. In December of 1848, President James Polk announced to the entire nation that huge amounts of the gold has been found in Northern California. President Polk was a great man. He invented television, and so a grateful nation. Their favorite card game was poker in his honor. So a grateful nation named their favorite card game poker in his honor. Becky, stop it! None of that is true. However, the entire nation did catch gold fever from New Land to New Orleans. People dreamed of getting rich in California. So this is Gold Fever Singers, song 3 out of 13. I think there might be 18 songs, I think. 20 songs, actually. Here we go. Gold fever, hello. Okay, so for right now, we're gonna skip the songs. I forgot, I was gonna say that. And then we'll get to the songs at the end, okay? But I will have to sing my song because I know all the moves to that one. You know, I had a fever once, 132 degrees. I was so hot, my socks caught on fire. That's enough, Becky. Neighbors came over to toast marshmallows on my nose. Hey, your stories remind me. Have you seen Sam around lately? Sam? No, not just the Calaveras County incident with the leaping toads. They were jumping frogs. We'll have to track him down. He knows a lot about the West. Meanwhile, it's just spring of 1849, and folks are flocking west. 40,000 are coming by land. It's no easy trip. Overlander, let me skip that. I myself came to California by wagon. I started my hotel and restaurant near Sacramento in September of 49. Got $10 on my first plate of biscuits. I came by blimp. You did not. Sure did. A giant blimp from Kansas City to San Francisco in 2 days. 2 days? They were very strong winds. Sam enters. Sam, you made it. The reports of my death are greatly exaggerated. You're just in time. We're about to hear from the folks who came to California by ship, and they call themselves Argonauts. Sailing for the Golden Fleece. I prefer steamboats on the Mississippi myself. I wish them well. Here we go. The waves are high, supplies are low. We're packed on deck, we're crammed below. But what is worse, there's else to do. You're sick of me, I'm tired of you. We're Argonauts. Rolling on some 6 month ocean trip. We're Argonauts. We're going on 16,000 miles by ship. We read the books, we met the foe. We sang that song, we've heard that joke. We played charades a million times. We've been the bar, we've shot the monks. We're Argonauts. 6 month ocean trip. We're Argonauts. Mm-hmm. We're going on 16,000 miles by ship. Mm-hmm. Hey everybody, let's dance. Yeah, I don't want to either. How about hide and go seek? Hello, is anybody awake here? We're Argonauts. Mm-hmm. We're going on a 6 month ocean trip. We're Argonauts. Mm-hmm. We're going on 16,000 miles by ship. That was the end of the song. I know you guys can't see me from here. Bring the camera over here, which is a real camera and not a phone. Now that's what I call roughing it. And life wasn't much easier, and they finally go out to the camps. I remember. Wait, did I start from now? Now that's what I call roughing it. And life wasn't much easier when they finally got out to the camps. Got out to the camp. I remember panning for gold was the toughest. I didn't make it to California until the 1860s. But I remember the summer weather. Boiling hot in the sun, the rivers felt by melting the snow. And don't forget the giant squid. But the miners didn't let anything stop them.
Not even the giant squid?
No, I saw many miners sinking from the awful lengths to poverty. Always hoping to strike, be rich. Pan miners. Oh, I like this song. I'm just one pan away from striking pay dirt. Just one pan away from being rich. Okay, I don't care. Johnny's about to come. Step on up, folks, and try your luck. Guess the year of fire in San Francisco. And win a vacation trip of all your dreams. Hello, folks. Come on over and test your skills on how you know your fire. Just $3 and you'll give your best prize. The gold rush brings out all kinds of people who like to take your money. What kind of a fool would fall for this? Hey, this looks great. It's just the place to spend my last $3, don't you think? You know my motto. Put all your eggs in one basket and watch that basket. Just $3, my good lady, and you're on your way to a fantastic vacation package worth over $2. Wow! Excellent. Now no help from the crowd. Here's your question. In which of the following years did San Francisco suffer a major fire? 1850, 1851, 1852, or 1853? This is a tough one. It seems to me that San Francisco was always burning down. That's absolutely correct. Okay, Johnny, tell the lucky lady what she's won. Better go home and pack, Becky, because we're sending you on a 6-day, 5-night whirlwind tour of the mining camps. You'll enjoy your first class accommodations in a wet tent in Fiddletown Red Dog and Poker Flat. You dine the best saloon in Squabbletown. Talk to burned out miners Mad Ox Riverine. Okay guys, this has like 25 pages and I'm barely on page 18. Look at this. 18, guys. It looks like 18. What was I? Oh. Squabbleton and Top to Bird Miners and the Mad Oaks Fiend to come all visit the tallest trees in Hangtown. And you'll end your dream vacation at Pottery Hill. It's all courtry of Know Your Fire, generously support by a grant from Leonard's Lumber Supply. I can't believe I won! Children with sticky note. Oh, they only have 3 paragraphs to memorize. You know, like a lot of women during the gold rush, I made a good living by offering food to lodging to the miner and lodging to the miner. Men could pay a good price for a home-cooked meal or some sewing or and washing. So guys, I'm barely on page 19. Help with this. Okay, now it just looks like 91. What is wrong with me? You sure made more money with your hotel than I did with some journalism. Why, Lucina, that Wilson's hotel of yours became a center of Brown New Town. A lot of famous people got their start at that time. I remember Gordon Nike sold his inflated heel. I call them Ear Gordons. Please, Becky. Then there was an old farmer, McDonald. One day he accidentally kicked a potato into a pan of bacon grease and invented French fries. He made a fortune. He even had the bottom of his feet gold plated to celebrate his discovery. I don't remember that. You mean you never had the golden arches of McDonald's? Thank goodness some real merchants are here to tell us about the truth. A lot of people did do well, but a lot... 17 minutes. I'm on page 21 already, guys. Please help me with this. That's like 12. What is wrong with me? A lot of people did do well, but a lot lost everything. I invested $10,000, everything I had, and barely. That was ruined by a flood. Wow. Oh my God, it's ruined by a flood. And don't forget the Native Americans and Californians. The folks who were here long before the gold rush, they were often treated harshly by the miners. That's no lie, Sam. I think I might finish under 21, 30 minutes. I think it's 30 minutes because they do the songs. But I'm not doing the songs. I hate the songs. Reminds me of another motto of mine. You should always do right. This graffiti gratified some people and astonished the rest. Astonished. It did not hurt. Even the most miners who stuck it out and had to give up the digging in the winters and move to San Francisco or Sacramento. Sorry, covering my face, guys. Put the camera right here. Nope. Sunlighting? No, not good sunlighting. Comment down below if you guys think this is good sunlighting or this is good sunlighting. I usually think this is good sunlighting. You bet! The coldest winter I've ever spent was a summer in San Francisco. Let's listen to these miners. City miners. We've got those cows sinking, socks stinking. What the heck were we thinking? Wait for the wintertime blues. So guys, I'm gonna end this here, and we ended off at page 23, and I'm actually surprised. We just needed one more page. But I'll see you guys next time.